I want to ask for forgiveness now if I sound sluggish, because I didn't even look at food. I had like some coffee. We usually try to get food before we come up, yeah. Or I just had coffee.
And I don't think food. I've ever seen you drink coffee before. That's the thing about it.
I'm in a food slug. Like I went crazy. I went crazy yesterday. You don't understand how crazy it was.
Yeah.
Then I didn't watch football because there was no Steelers Ravens game, so I didn't watch football that night. Yeah. So it was just me staring at food. You know?
Well, it looks like the captains are coming to the field for the pregame coin toss. Gators in their home green jersey, old gold pants, gold helmets, kind of a classic retro alternate Georgia or Notre Dame color scheme there. Knights are in their road whites, white jerseys with green accents, white pants, gunmetal gray helmets. From what we saw from the package that was handed out by the media office here, looks like it's going to be Josh Meadows as the captain tonight for the one out of the 16 seniors
right
that are playing.
So tonight
on this Frederica
team, they're not doing the senior stare down where they bring all the seniors out tonight.
No, they didn't. They did not bring all 16 of the seniors out to the coin flip this time. And it doesn't look like Josh Meadows is going to be one that will be coming out to midfield for the coin flip. The other players out there looks like Joshua Elliott, Will Thompson, and Will Counts. So the Wills and Joshua standing on the sideline waiting for the coin flip with Josh Meadows, who also, even though last week we were talking about that on the Coach Brandon Derrick show this past Sunday night at Porch, 8 o'clock, 1440 WGIG 98.7 FM, brought to you by Soundbite Aviation. We were talking about the fact that he was playing at less than 100%. He did not have full range of motion in one of his arms.
Mm.
Still managed to block two punts.
Crazy.
So crazy. Josh Meadows is the X factor on the defense for these Knights.
And didn't he have? He had a great offensive game last time he played.
2 weeks ago, when we played Pinewood, he had a great game. He had a couple of just absolutely terrific seam passes.
Pinewood. Yeah, right.
Against Pinewood, but then did not play on offense at all last week against Trinity Christian. Was completely on defense,
right.
And showed that he still has got what it takes on the defense.
What's the first round of the playoffs? Expect some tricks to come out tonight. Nothing less. Pull out all the stops.
Yeah, I think that's going to be absolutely the case. And, you know, Coach Brandon Derrick has been known to get a little creative.
Right.
So we might see that tonight as well on that. So we have, coin flip. I didn't even see what it wound up as. All right. We got the looks like, we'll figure out what happened. Let's take a look. We still have another break?
We got
to take that break. We'll be back. Frederica Knights football, Christmas on cue.
Like the Gators will be receiving. Number two, Rodney Hill, back deep receiving.
And we're back, ready for the Velocity Zone fireworks kickoff. The Knights won the toss, deferred to the second half, so they are going to be kicking off to the Gators to start off this evening. And we are just moments away. Eli Fritchman lining up for the Velocity Zone fireworks kickoff. We are ready for this first game of the GISA playoffs. Frederica Knights versus the Bulloch Academy Gators. It's going to be a classic. It's a gorgeous night tonight. About 57 degrees out, about 85% humidity, no wind to speak of. A little bit of a wind. That smoke from the pregame pyrotechnics not hanging in the air quite as much as it was the last time we were here. It's actually moving across the field this time. But we are getting ready for the kickoff. Here comes Eli Fitchman, and it is a short end over ends coming down. Fair catch. Call for the 25 and bobble. It's bouncing backwards. Nice Frederica pass. Picks up at the 20-yard line. Tries to carry up through the middle. And there's just an absolute cacophony, craziness. Play is blown dead, even though the player has still got the ball. Really, wow.
Just seemed like a lot of jitters and nerves coming out in that kickoff. Bullet. Definitely having to take care of the ball because the Knights are frisky on special teams.
Now, I'm wondering if that wasn't another one of those targeted kicks that Frederica has been known to do. They'll see if somebody has got a little bit of a weakness when it comes to fielding the ball, and they'll start kicking directly to him. That might have been that.
Definitely.
All right, so the Knights lining up on defense, ready to go. Gators come to the line. Single receiver on the far side, tight ends. Single back lining up behind the quarterback. He's under shotgun or under center. Tight end in motion. Here's the snap. Gibbs to the back. Tries to take up the middle, and he's going to be bouncing all over the place. And, man, he is trying to break tackles, but nothing doing. Jacob Aiken finally brings him down right at the line of scrimmage. Right at the line of scrimmage. So no gain on the play.
And it's interesting to see Bulloch come out running strong because last game, their running back had a big second half, but we really didn't see him till the second half.
Yeah, they come out running. They were a much heavier passing team to start off with that last time. They had a good call on that one, Callie Cole. Here go the Gators on their opening drive. Here's second play. Two receivers to the near side. Here's the snap. Gives to that back again. Tries to take it to the inside. Bounces out to the far side. Getting around the corner. He's got a little bit of a lane. He's got a whole bunch of running room there. He's going to outrun the entire Frederica defense. Holy cow. One man trips him up and is brought down inside the 10. Ouch.
Big play from Bryce Rodney stopping the touchdown. Big play. That's what you got to do. Keep running to the end. Even though that was just about a 70-yard run that Bulloch Academy just executed, the Knights stopping them. And they're always tough on that goal line. So we'll see what the Knights defense does.
All right. So they're going to have it down at the – looks like they're marked it down at the 4-yard line, first and goal. It says the 5 on the scoreboard, but from where it looks like it's posted on the field, that's a short 5.
Man, explosive running.
Yeah. All right, first and goal for the Gators. Line up in that same formation. Receivers on either side, plus the back. Quarterback under center sends the receiver in motion. Short, that was a false start on the Gators. They're going to back it up 5 and try it again.
A lot of momentum and a lot of nerves. And for them to come out in the first drive and get a big play like that, wow.
We are a minute, 25 seconds into the game. We've got our first penalty of the night against the Gators. So it's going to be second and goal, or first and goal from the 9.
Yeah, the Knights have to stay mentally strong because you can still get a stop. Even after a big play like that, as long as there's no end zone, you can still get a stop.
All right. Lining up, tight end off the line. One receiver way on the near side, another on the far side. The handoff hits the back, tries to take it up the middle. Flying in from the corners. Who is that for the Knights? Bringing that tackle down on that.
Josh Meadows.
Who else but Josh Meadows?
Nice gang tackling, and the Knights are coming back poised. Even after a big run like that, not having a broken spirit, making a big tackle, it's just one play in one series.
All right, so second, they're going to give him 3 yards on the play, so second goal from the 6-yard line. Knights defense showing they can bend but not break, at least for that first play. Let's see if they can make it happen 2 more times.
Yeah, Bryce Riley making that tackle at the end of that play is coming up big right now.
Two receivers on to the near side for the Gators. Single back in the backfield, quarterback under center. Here's the snap. He keeps it himself. He's trying to get around the corner to the far side. He's got a man running, and he's going to be tripped up. Not before he falls into the end zone. Touchdown, Bulloch. Bulloch Academy quarterback keeps the ball himself, bounces out to the outside, to the near side, and into the end zone for the first score of the game.
Bulloch Academy coming out strong with the running game. Like I said earlier, the second half was when they really just let out the running game arsenal. We're seeing them start off early, and the Knights are going to have to figure out a way to not let them get big plays.
So now the Gators lining up for the extra point. 6 points on the board with 9:14 left in the first. Knights defense trying to block that kick. Not going to block it, but doesn't matter. That was true, high, long, and it's good. 7-0 is the score here. 9:14 left in the first. Going to take a quick break. We'll be back. 30 seconds. Frederica Knights football. Christmas on cue.
Beachview Event Rentals and Design is a full-service event company
with a resolution to provide clients with innovative inventory, ideas, and customer service. Our carefully curated collection of tents, lighting, linens, furniture, and tableware are sure to bring your vision to life and create a truly memorable event. The Beachview crew makes sure to bring the creativity, fun, and excellent customer service that has been winning us the appreciation and respect of all our clients for 20 years to each project.
You love the game, but you don't love the pain. From the moment an injury sidelines you, turn to the experts at Summit Sports Medicine and Orthopedic Surgery. Our winning team of physicians and orthopedic surgeons will design a treatment plan just for you, so you can get back in the game quickly and safely. To play your best, you need to work with the best. Visit sghs.org/summit or call 912-466-7340 to schedule your appointment.
My coach was showing some great field vision. He actually was, I was thinking he was coming to the left side of the field, and then he just cut it right back up to the right side and got about a 20-yard scamper out of that chain.
Yeah, they're going to actually mark him down at the 44, but it's still starting off with a short field on the Bulloch Academy side of the field. First and 10 for the Knights from the Bulloch 44. It's not going to be I formation. It's going to be in gun. Veal in at quarterback, triplet to his right. He's going to send Kyle Perez in motion, hand off to him, tries to cut to the outside. He's going to hit at the line of scrimmage and bounce out of bounds for no gain.
A tough no gain run, yeah, from Kyle Perez. He lets the defender feel it at the end of the run, I'll tell you that.
Yeah, he was lined up at the wide receiver position. They're actually going to give him about a half a yard a gain, or no, it's going to be about a half yard loss. It's going to be second and 11. Second and a short 11, 8:58 left in the first quarter. The announcer saying the same thing as me. Two receivers either side of the line, single back is triplet, sends the tight end in motion. Here's the snap. Give is triplet. Hits some traffic in the middle. And is going to be met just shy of the line of scrimmage. He's going to be brought down. Going to get it back to the original line of scrimmage, so it's going to be now third and 10.
Yeah, Bulloch Academy's defense coming out tough. You can tell they're feeling that momentum from the offense and coming out making a big hit. Interested in seeing how Jordan Triplett's going to run tonight, because he looks like he's kind of patient right now.
Quick update, Brunswick, Iowa with a 7-0 lead over Alcabee early in the first quarter there in Covington. It's 7-0, Bulloch over Frederica here with 8:19 and counting here. Back into the I formation here. Shotgun for Veal, fakes the give, looking to throw long down the sidelines into coverage, and it's going to be incomplete. He's trying to get it out there to Josh Meadows in at wide receiver, and nothing doing on that play. So it's going to be fourth and 11, and the Knights might be going for it on fourth and 11, or they may be punting. We'll have to wait and see here.
Yeah, looks like they're going to punt and play for some field position, but good series by the Knights. At least they got to run through some plays and see what it's going to be like. Tough series, though, for the running game.
Yeah, very, very tough indeed. So it is going to be a punt. Eli Fritchman standing back at their own 43-yard line, almost over his head, but brings it down in a nice, tight spiral punt. Going to hit it about the 20-yard line. Takes a little bit of a Frederica bounce. It's going to be down at about the 14-yard line. So that's where the Bulloch Academy Gators will take off on their second offensive series of the Knights.
Man, the Knights have to be thinking about that last series and thinking no big plays.
Yep, because that's one of the things that Coach Brandon Derrick talked about on the Coach Brandon Derrick Show this past Sunday night, 8 o'clock at Ports, brought to you by Standby Aviation on 1440 WGIG. He talked about limit turnovers, limit the big plays, play clean. So, and unfortunately, that's one that has already fallen by the wayside, that big 70-yard run on the Gators' first offensive series, leading to a relatively easy score. 7-0 is the score. Bulloch in the lead over your Frederica Knights, and they've got the ball back on offense. Quarterback hands it off to the running back, who's going to try and go straight ahead and then bounced off to the right side. Nothing doing. That's the line of scrimmage for the stop. It's going to be 2nd and 10.
And they're going to have to take it a play at a time. This Knights defense is going to have to make a stop every time the ball comes out the backfield, every pass play, because Bulloch is aggressive tonight.
7:30 and counting here in the first quarter. Knights are on defense at the moment, and they are facing Bulloch Academy. He's got a 7-0 lead at the moment. Bulloch's got 2nd and 9. They gave him a yard on that play, so 2nd and 9 from the 12-yard line. Here's the snap. He's out into the flat, and he's going to be met and slammed down for a loss there. Chase Schuneman with the big stop on the loss. Great play from the junior.
Excellent tackling once again from this secondary. The Knights, it doesn't matter what level of defense, they all can make big plays and make big stops. And you've seen Schuneman come up almost in time for a pick.
Yeah, he just about jumped the play on that one, but did stop him at the line of scrimmage. So it's going to be, well, they're going to give him one more yard. Yeah. So it's going to be 3rd and 8.
Even though it looked like a loss on that one.
It was 3rd and 9 from the 12 on the last play. Now it's 3rd and 8 from the 12. Anyway, 3rd and long regardless here. The Gators lining up, 2 receivers on the far side of the field. Here's the snap. Quarterback rolling out to the near side. He's looking to throw, and it's going to be complete, but short of the first down. Wasn't able to make it out of bounds. It's going to be a couple yards shy. Clock continues to run. It's going to be 4th and short for the Gators. Deep in their own territory, more than likely we're going to see the Gators punting game here.
Yeah, the Knights came out and gave a little cushion to the receivers, and the Knights are lucky that the receiver just simply didn't know what it was.
Yep.
When you run that type of route, have to know where the marker is so you can complete it. That's not on the quarterback. That's on the receiver. Knights really lucked up with that one.
That they did. 4th and 1 from the 21, and it looks like they're going to be punting it. Back to receive is Jaden Rose Scally and Eli Fritchman, and punt is off. It's going to be short. It's going to be fielded by Rose Galley. He called for the fair catch, and it's going to be right at the 50-yard line. We'll take a quick break, 30 seconds. Frederica Knights football, 103Q, Christmas on Q.
Provide clients with innovative inventory, ideas, and customer service. Our carefully curated collection of tents, lighting, linens, furniture, and tableware are sure to bring your vision to life and create a truly memorable event. The Beachview crew makes sure to bring the creativity, fun, and excellent customer service that has been winning us the appreciation and respect of all our clients for 20 years to each project.
You love the game, but you don't love the pain. From the moment an injury sidelines you, turn to the experts at Summit Sports Medicine and Orthopedic Surgery. Our winning team of physicians and orthopedic surgeons will design a treatment plan just for you, so you can get back in the game quickly and safely. To play your best, you need to work with the best. Visit sghs.org/summit or call 912-466-7340 to schedule your appointment.
It's Frederica. Knights have got 2nd and 9 from the Bulloch Academy 49-yard line. I formation, Beal standing in the shotgun. He's got Triplett standing behind him, 2 receivers to the far side, 1 to the near. It's Bryce Riley. Sends tight end in motion. Here's the snap. Fakes the give to Triplett, rolls out to the far side. Beal's going to keep it himself. He's down the sideline. He's got a first down and then some. Knocked out of bounds at about the 38-yard line. There's those legs that Thomas Beal finally realized he's got.
He has those turn-the-corner legs. A lot of quarterbacks can't get around the edge, but Beal can chop it up real quick. You got to watch him.
good decision-making there from the junior quarterback. So a fair and fair first down. Back into the same lineup as well. 2 receivers to the far side. Looks like it's Riley and Scally, Rose Scally on the far side. Triplett standing behind Veal in the I formation. And they're looking at, to Coach Grant and Derek for a little guidance there. 4:40 on the clock and rolling here. Tidying off the line, sending him in motion. Here's the snap. Gibbs to Triplett, looking for something. Bounces out to the outside. Spin move, gets some yardage. He's going to hit a couple of Gators. Going to be shy of the first down. Man, he was so close to breaking that one open. But he gets some good positive yardage on the play regardless.
Yeah, he made a way out of no way because he came up to the line, jumped back out, bounced it outside, and then the spin move, the one-on-one move, that's what's scary. When you get a running back who can get to the outside and break a defender down one-on-one, he's a dangerous dude.
Second and four from the 32-yard line with 4:10 left in the first quarter. Knights trying to get another fair and fair a first down here. Eye formation again, two receivers to the far side. Field standing behind Triplett. They're on the near hash mark. Here's the snap. Fakes the give. Quick out into the flats to Fritchman. He's got the first down. Trips up, but he's got enough for the fair and fair first down and down inside the 25 to the 23-yard line. First down Knights.
And Mason McGraw, man, sealing that block up there, holding him just enough time so Eli Fritchman can get a couple more yards.
Beautiful play out in the flats for the Knights on that one.
Yeah.
High formation again. Rose Scaly in that receiver on the near side. He's by himself. Single receiver on the far side. Mason.
Thank you. They're talking.
Beachview Event Rentals and Design is a full-service event company with a resolution to provide clients with innovative inventory, ideas, and customer service. Our carefully curated collection of tents, lighting, linens, furniture, and tableware are sure to bring your vision to life and create a truly memorable event. The Beachview crew makes sure to bring the creativity, fun, and excellent customer service that has been winning us the appreciation and respect of all our clients for 20 years to each project.
You love the game, but you don't love the pain. From the moment an injury sidelines you, turn to the experts at Summit Sports Medicine and Orthopedic Surgery. Our winning team of physicians and orthopedic surgeons will design a treatment plan just for you, so you can get back in the game quickly and safely. To play your best, you need to work with the best. Visit sghs.org/summit or call 912-466-7340 to schedule your appointment.
Doubler picks up players so much for us.
Pass incomplete. Brings up a third down. Last turn about 16.
Oh, nice 72. Get him, Will. Sean, talk about 57. 72, proud of you.
Tom Cruise.
Stand up!
Call it unsportsmanlike conduct. Yes, it might.
Dang it! Of course it is!
That'd be 15 yards of automatic touchdown.
foul out. Nice.
I got Molly True.
Thank you.
Looks like we'll be short for the yard line today by 1 yard.
Oh, short for 1 yard.
Thank you.
Yes, sir.
Beachview Event Rentals and Design is a full-service event company
with a resolution to provide clients with innovative inventory,
ideas,
and customer service. Our carefully curated collection of tents, lighting, linens, furniture, and tableware are sure to bring your vision to life and create a truly memorable event. The Beachview crew makes sure to bring the creativity, fun, and excellent customer service that has been winning us the appreciation and respect of all our clients for 20 years to each project.
You love the game, but you don't love the pain. From the moment an injury sidelines you to Turn to the experts at Summit Sports Medicine and Orthopedic Surgery. Our winning team of physicians and orthopedic surgeons will design a treatment plan just for you, so you can get back in the game quickly and safely. To play your best, you need to work with the best. Visit sghs.org/summit or call 912-466-7340 to schedule your appointment.
Dogs on the stop. Thank you.
Thank you.
That's what I'm talking about. Yeah, you know why not? Pretty boy coming through.
And we're back. Teams are wrapping up their post-halftime calisthenics, and we are ready to kick off the second half of this playoff football matchup in Statesboro, Georgia, Bulloch Academy, and your Frederica Knights. 14-13 is the score as we get ready to start off the second half. Knights in the lead by a single point. Compliments of the missed extra point from the Bulloch Academy Gators. And, you know, it's really been just a solid half of football.
Definitely.
You know, some problems with the penalties earlier on, but they calmed down on that. It's just a matter now of playing the game like Coach Derek has coached them to do.
Now, this is the part of the game where my nerves get bad because everything is so important at this part of the game. It's crazy.
All right, so now we are ready for the second half kickoff, the Velocity Zone Fireworks kickoff. As always, thanks so much to our sponsors, Velocity Zone Fireworks, for the sponsoring the kickoffs. Farrah and Farrah sponsoring the first downs. And as always, Standby Aviation for sponsoring the Coach Brandon Derrick Show every Sunday night, 8 o'clock at Porch on St. Simon's Island. Come out and join us. It's always a lot of fun. Definitely. Or you can listen to it over on their sibling station, 1440 WGIG and 98.7 FM. So here we are with the Velocity Zone Fireworks kickoff to start off the second half. Knight's going to be receiving it. It's in a short kick, and it's caught at about the 42-yard line, in through some traffic and pushed out of bounds on the far side. Did not see who was it that caught that.
Eli Fritchman.
Was it Fritchman? They're kicking at him quite often tonight. Right. I wonder why that is.
Right.
Point being, though, he made the catch clean, got some extra yardage out of it, and it's going to be first and 10 for the Knights at the Frederica 47-yard line.
So we'll see if the Knights come out aggressive running or if they're going to mix it up a little bit and get Veal going a little bit on this drive.
Well, we may have a little bit of mix-up going on already, getting things mixed up, because once again, Meatball Perez lining up at wide receiver. He and Bryce Riley on the near side, got two on the far side, and Veal in the backfield with Triplett to his right. Going to send Perez in motion. Here's the snap, fakes the handoff to him, gives it to Veal, takes it through the A-gap and met at the line, slung down for a loss of about a yard. Hard tackle there, too.
Man, and the Gators just kind of swarmed that line, and really it looked like Triplett was going to get some room, but, I mean, they just were explosive in stopping a run on that play.
Yeah, good cross-field coverage for the Bulloch linebackers on that one, able to plug up that hole before Triplett was able to get there, before Veal was able. Yeah, Triplett, I had it right the first time.
Yeah.
Was able to get anything going there. So it's second and 10. They gave him forward progress back to the line of scrimmage. Second and 10 from the 47-yard line. Single receiver to the near side is Riley. Two receivers to the far side. Here's the snap. Veal rolling to the far side. Steps up into the pocket. He's got pressure. It's collapsing. Gets back to the line of scrimmage. Looked like he was going to try and make a run at it. Nothing doing, though. Back to the line of scrimmage, though. Going to give him a yard on the play. So it's going to be third and 9 from the 48.
So the Knights have to figure out how they can advance. Maybe go back to that Mason McGraw play.
Yeah.
Or maybe actually get a pitch going or a misdirection. Something to throw at the defense, because right now they're not biting on anything.
Yeah, third and 9 from the 48, 10:30. We're 90 seconds into the third quarter here. 14-13 is the score. Frederica's got the lead, but they're looking to add to it. They've got 53 yards to make that happen right now. Shifting things up, Josh Meadows back in, and looks like Frederica's early in the game going to have to take a timeout. Confusion I guess it's the dulcet tones of Brian Johnson and AC/DC had them shook there. All right. Yeah, we'll take a quick break. We'll be back 30 seconds. Frederica Knights football, Christmas on cue.
Beachview Event Rentals and Design is a full-service event company
with a resolution to provide clients with innovative inventory, ideas, and customer service. Our carefully curated collection of tents, lighting, linens, furniture, and tableware are sure to bring your vision to life and create a truly memorable event. The Beachview crew makes sure to bring the creativity, fun, and excellent customer service that has been winning us the appreciation and respect of all our clients for 20 years to each project.
You love the game, but you don't love the pain. From the moment an injury sidelines you, turn to the experts at Summit Sports Medicine and Orthopedic Surgery. Our winning team of physicians and orthopedic surgeons will design a treatment plan just for you, so you can get back in the game quickly and safely. To play your best, you need to work with the best. Visit sghs.org/summit or call 912-466-7340 to schedule your appointment.
Hold on for the punt. Good snap. And a good punt, tight spiral, going to hit at the 35 and take a Frederica bounce to the 30, inside the 30, down to the 25-yard line. But the referee is going to say that it bounced off one of the Frederica players at the 21-yard line. So that's where the Gators will start off here and where the Knights will begin their first defensive series of the evening. Up 14-13 with 10:07 left in the third quarter.
You know, special teams, when you're gunning down the field, you definitely have to watch for that ball. Sometimes you run ahead of it, and the ball gets to roll, and it'll hit you right in the legs. And that's what we've seen. Frederica lost about 5 extra yards that they could have had on the punt. Not much, yeah, but just probably about 5.
Yeah, 5 yards makes a difference. Just ask the Knights that this first game against Bulloch Academy this year.
Definitely.
All right. Quarterback under center for the Gators. Fakes the handoff, keeps it himself, comes around the corner. He's going to be tripped up and slammed to the ground just shy of the 30. Going to give him about 3, maybe 4 yards on the play.
And the quarterback has been real explosive for the Gators tonight with that option, mainly because you don't know if he's going to hand it to the running back, and Hill is so explosive. So that option is really going to be seen a lot this second half. I would think so, because it's been working.
In case you missed it earlier, Pinewood is down 28-7 to Tift Area in the fourth quarter over in Belleville. Winner of that game will play the winner of this game next week. Fullback or tight end in motion for the Gators. Here's the snap. Fakes the give again. He's trying to find a lane, trying to get around the corner. Nothing doing. Finally gets pushed out of bounds. Man, he was just dancing to stay inside that sideline. The people were getting knocked out of bounds all around him. But it's enough for a first down for the Gators.
And it seems like some folks on the Gator sideline were kind of looking for a personal foul to be called. But you almost can't not hit somebody that close to out of bounds or make sure you're driving, especially somebody with some footwork like that. Their quarterback is just
– Yeah, especially and especially when you got so many of the coaching staff and the other players standing that close to the sideline,
Definitely.
All right, first and 10 from the 29 with 9:15 left in the third quarter here. Bulloch Academy on their own 34-yard line. Two receivers to the far side. Double tight end set. Sends a receiver in motion to the near side. Here's the snap. Gibbs to the back. Tries to take it up the middle, and he is met and brought down after a very short gain.
That's probably about the first time he's been stopped like that tonight.
Yeah.
Hands on the ball.
Yeah, number two for the Gators is not anything to be messed with, and that is it's been odd that they have not been riding him as much as they should be tonight. If they have been been feeding him the ball as much as we have been feeding Jordan Triplett the ball,
right,
it would be a completely different game. I'm glad they're not doing that.
Right, they have their reasons, I guess.
All right, so 3 yards on the play, so second and 7 with 8:35 left in the third. One receiver on either side of the line, double tight end, sends one of them in motion. Here's the snap. Hands it off to number 20. Tries to take it through the 3-gap. Nothing doing. Brought down after a gain of about a yard and a half. He's just short of the 40.
Yeah, nice hit from Josh Elliott and Will Counts. Really gang tackling, and that's what they're really going to have to do every time they see somebody with the ball from the Gators trying to make a big play. You got to gang tackle every one of these guys down to the quarterback.
Critical third down play here for the Knights. Third and five, the Gators on their own 39-yard line here with just under 8 minutes left in the third. 14-13 is the score. Frederica in the lead. Bulloch Academy's got the ball. Quarterback is under center. Single back behind him. Two receivers, one on either side of the line. Here's the snap. He's rolling back to the near side. He's looking to throw, and it's going to be out of bounds, incomplete. So it's going to be fourth and five. And they have not been shy about going for it on fourth tonight. Let's see if they're going to be feeling their oats here. Fourth and five at their own 39.
Looks like they're going to.
That's about where the Knights have been starting off on offense.
So it looks like they're going to. Man, the Knights are getting a big stop. Getting a big stop. That's a major stop.
Yep, they are going to punt it. So we've got Meatball Perez. No, I'm sorry. Got Rose Scally and Eli Fritchman back to receive, standing at about the 32-yard line. Here's the snap. Good snap. Oh, man, Bryce Riley almost got another block. Fair catch called by Rose Scally. Wow. Bobbled it a little bit, but fell on top of it. Retains possession, so he's got it down at the 21-yard line. Boy, you can hear the reactions in this booth, can't
right.
you?
and it's just one of those things that with fielding a punt, it's literally the highest you can see the ball go. You're trying to avoid the lights. Then, just on that play, the defender was literally breathing down Scally's neck. So, you know, holding on to the ball is tough in that situation. But playoff football, you got to get on it. And that's what he did. He got on the ball.
7:29 left in the third. 14-13 is your score. The Knights take back over on offense on their own 21-yard line. Veal standing in the backfield. Looks like we got Meatball Perez lining up at back on this down. We've got Fritchman to the near side. Two receivers to the far side. Yeah, pistol formation is going to send the tight end in motion. Here's the snap. Going to toss it out to Meatball. He's getting ahead of steam, but he's met in the backfield. Loss of five on the play. Ouch.
Man, big play. And we've been seeing these linebackers from the Gators really seal the outside.
Yeah.
There hasn't been a lot of bouncing out tonight for the Knights.
Yeah, six-yard loss on the play back to the 15-yard line. 7:07 and rolling here in the third quarter.
And I'm seeing so much cushion from the cornerback to the Gators. I'm wondering if the Knights are going to go back to that little comeback route.
You would think so.
There's a lot of cushion out here.
Rose Scally and Fritchman, the receivers to the near side.
Or even that stop and go route at this point.
Single receiver to the far side is Mason McGraw. Triplet back in the backfield now. Here's the snap. Veal drops back to throw. He's got pressure coming in and knocked out of bounds. Man, should have thrown that one away, but he holds on to it. It's going to be a third and a country mile from our 9-yard line.
And
ouch.
And it's one of those plays in a close game where you have to almost tell yourself there will be another down and get rid of the ball. you have to convince yourself, unless you're like Russell Wilson or somebody.
Yep. Knights moving the wrong way on this drive. Third and 22 from the 9-yard line. 6:06. They must have tackled him before he went out of bounds on that far side of the field.
Yeah, Villa's got to commit to the run earlier when he's rolling out.
Yep. All right. Again, I formation for the Knights. Two receivers to the near, one to the far. Tight end in motion. Here's the snap. Give is the Veal. Tries to take it to the outside. Bumps it out to the outside. He's got a good bit of running there. Oh, and that side judge was thinking about tossing that flag. He wasn't sure if that was a face mask or not. I don't know.
Yeah. Woo.
Respectable run gets us back to inside the original 10 yards, but not enough for the first down. It's going to be fourth and eight, and the Knights going to have to punt.
I'm looking at the replay on the stream. It doesn't look like you really can't
maybe
tell.
Maybe an incidental
it's a pass.
There at the very end. Yeah. But regardless, punt formation for the Knights. Receiver for the Gator standing his own 46-yard line. It's going to be some painful field position. But a good kick, and it's going to be caught at the 45. Fair catch called for. 5:02 left in the third. Let's take a quick break. 30 seconds. Frederica Knights football. Christmas on cue. We're still at 14-13 here in the third quarter. Bulloch has got it first and 10 from their own 45-yard line. Pistol formation, trip receivers to the far side. Quarterback looks like he's going to be ready for another option play. But the pocket collapses, and he's got a swarm of white jerseys bringing him down for a loss of 5 yards back to the 40.
Man,
there we go.
Definitely was a gang tackling situation, but Josh Meadows was the first Knight to get his hands wrapped on him, and he didn't let him go.
Glen Academy added another 7 points onto their lead. It's now 28-3 with a little less than 8 minutes left to go in the third at Glen County Stadium. 14-13 is the score here in Bulloch. Frederica still holding on to a one-point lead, a tenuous grasping one-point lead here with 4:25 and counting left in the third. Bulloch's got the ball, lost a three on that last play, so it's going to be 2nd and 13 from the 42-yard line. Quarterback in the shotgun. He's got trip receivers to the far side, single back to his left. Here's the snap. He's looking to throw again. He's, again, telegraphing that near side. He's going to zip it out, and it's going to be caught, but it's going to be shy of the first down by about a yard and a half. So it's going to be 3rd and short for the Knights. So then just over for the Gators, with just under 4 minutes to play now here.
Yeah, the Knights are going to have to make a big stop because the run is coming. The run is coming.
It is, but you know, the crazy thing about this, that this quarterback for the Gators is, I have never seen a quarterback telegraph every single throw as badly as he is throwing. And we got a flag coming in from the back, Judge. What in the world is this?
Must be too many
What
players.
Do we have here? Oh, there we go. You got 12 men on the field on the Gators, so they're going to march it back. So that 3rd and a yard. That's a big break for the Knights. So 3rd and a yard turned into 3rd and 6, just like that.
They definitely caught a break.
3:33 and counting left on the field. And man, there is a Generation Xer with some serious 80s fixation running the soundboard tonight. We've got some Beastie Boys and Brass Monkey thumping the bass here in Bulloch Academy. This is something else. All right, two receivers either side of the line for the Gators. Single back in the backfield to the right of the quarterback. Here's the snap. He's looking to throw to the near side. Pocket collapse and looking again to throw. And it's going to be incomplete, almost intercepted. Man, Eli Fritchman just about read that one.
Big play by Eli Fritchman. I mean, literally the receiver probably had like a whole head's length on him too, but he jumped up in there and knocked the ball down.
I'm sorry, go ahead.
And that's what you want to see for your safeties. You want to see them awake and running at the ball. We see that from the secondary from the Knights. They actually attack when the ball is in the air.
So 4th and 6 from the 49-yard line, just under 3 minutes to play, and they're punting.
Do you think any of the kids on the field know what Brass Monkey is?
I would hope so. I would hope that my generation, which are the parents of these kids, have given their kids the proper musical education. Here's the punt. Not as much pressure this time, but it's going to be Rose Scally holding on to it again, and he gets it to the 25-yard line this time.
So the Knights still up, and they're getting the ball at the end of the third quarter. What an opportunity is.
Man. Yeah. Well, geez.
We still really don't know anything about this game.
No, we don't.
We sit here and watch. There's been some big plays, but we still don't know anything about this game. Nobody's really in control.
Man, oh, man. I'm going to look up real quick, see if we've got any updates on the Tift area Pinewood game. 28-7, still the last update that we had available on that one. It's 14-3 here. Frederica has got a one-point lead against Bulloch Academy. They've got a 1st and 10 from their own 25-yard line here with 2:50 left in the third quarter. Single receiver to the near side is Fritchman. Two receivers to the far side. Single back lined up in the pistol formation. Tight end goes in motion. Give is to Triplett, taking it through the 3-gap. Gets a couple yards, keeps those feet moving. There's a lot of traffic and not a lot of space. The coaches for Bulloch Academy trying to say that there was a turnover on that, but referees disagree.
Yeah, I'm watching on the replay. Looks like he was already, momentum already stopped. Yeah, he was already down. He was already down when the ball came out.
All right, 2:26 and counting here in the third quarter, 14-3 the score. Frederica's got the lead and the ball and a 2nd and 6 from their own 29-yard line. Bryce Riley, Eli Fritchman, two receivers on the near side of the ball of the field. Far side looks to be Rose Scally and McGraw, maybe. single back in the backfield with Beal is Triplett. Here's the snap, looking to throw, zips it out, intercepted, and brought down at the 25-yard line.
Man, the Gators, they literally been waiting and sitting on that play. That's been a nice bread and butter tonight, going to that comeback route. And the corner just sat on it and read it perfectly. Yep. He sat in that spot.
Yep. It's probably the reason why we haven't seen that play nearly as much in the third quarter as we had seen it all first half.
They went in, made some adjustments, and the Knights definitely have to make a goal line stand because they do not want to give the Gators a lead going into the fourth quarter.
No, absolutely not. That was just tough. Thomas Veal has not been throwing a lot of interceptions this season.
Right. Yeah, they basically set on that route.
First and 10 for the Gators at the Frederica 24-yard line is where they've got it. Quarterback under center. Toss number two. He's trying to get around that corner, and he's going to get knocked out of bounds. Lost a yard on the play. Wow, so a lot of northwest or east-west, not a lot of north-south on that one.
And when you're facing an athlete like that in the backfield, you have to create a wall. You can't send one or two defenders at him because he has a stiff arm and he has speed.
Lost a yard on the play, makes it second and 11 from the 25-yard line.
It's a good play by Knights, swarming the ball, getting there, and not giving them the edge.
We're inside of 2 minutes left in the third quarter, 14-3 the score. But Bulloch has just taken the lead on the has moved ahead on the turnover battle 2-0. Single back, going to send that tight end in motion. Quarterback under center.
Yep.
And we got a false start.
They jump. I seen it.
False start. You seen it? Good.
Which one was that? I seen the jump. Number 72. I seen the jump.
All right. So march it back another 5 and try it again. So second and 16 now. The referees giveth and the referees taketh away.
You know, when the O-line jumps like that, the play that was called was a doozy.
Yeah.
And so we just lucked up. We lucked up. They were in their bread and butter mode.
They know that was about to be a big one.
Yeah, that was going to be a big one.
Sorry, coach. All right, second and 16 from the 30-yard line. Minute 47 left in the third.
Got to watch this receiver on the far end.
Yep, moves back to an empty backfield. Quad receivers to the far side. Here's the snap. Quarterback looking to the near side. Pressure coming in up the middle. It's going to be intercepted. Eli Frenchman with an interception in the end zone. Knights get one. Falls their way. First and 10 at the 20.
That's what I'm talking about. When you're playing in the secondary, you're playing safety, and you're not sleep. Adjusting to the ball. Eli Fritchman has been watching him run that play about 2 or 3 times. He made the right play right there.
Wow, so the interception from Thomas Veal results in no points from the Bulloch Academy Gators. Eli Fritchman returning the favor, and it's now first and 10 Knights from their own 20-yard line.
Defense making a big stand for the Knights.
All right, looks like it's going to be pistol formation again for the Knights.
And I would definitely try to get some clock on this drive.
Yeah,
this
absolutely.
Drive right here is about the clock.
Single receivers either side of the line for the Knights. Moves from the pistol into the shotgun. Veal to the right, or to the triplet to the right of Veal. Here's the snap. Fakes the give, rolling to the near side. Looking to throw down the sideline. Almost intercepted again. Was trying to get it there to John Philip Spears. What do we have here? It's going to be a false start on the Knights.
But they're letting the play roll.
Yeah,
after
that's weird. I don't know why they're not stopping the play after the false start.
They're continuing to let the play roll.
That's dangerous. Mm. All right, so back it up. 10 yards. Try it again. We're backing up 5 yards. Okay.
As the song in the background says, don't make no sense. They need to stop. they need to stop the play from rolling when that happens.
All right, first and 15 from the 15. Minute 31 left in the third quarter here. Knights have got a 14-13 lead, and they're trying to add to it. Big Eli Fritchman interception setting this up, but a false start penalty backs it up 5. All by himself in the backfield. He's got Fritchman in motion. The give is to Fritchman. No, it was a keeper. Oh, my goodness. Veal is running down the field. No, I'm sorry. That's not Veal. That's Triplett. Triplett. It was again with the Wildcat, and he's got a touchdown. Holy cow.
No fouls on the play.
No flags.
No flags.
He faked the handoff. He faked the handoff to Frenchman so good it had me fooled. I thought the Frenchman had lost another 7 yards, but he kept the ball in the Cherokee formation, runs it to the far side, down the sidelines, 85 yards for the touchdown. The River, Jordan Triplett.
And he's literally been holding that run in all game. That was like the most explosive I've seen him come out the backfield. He knew he was going straight north and south.
Eli Frenchman lining up for the extra point here. And bobbles it. And Riley tries to pick it up and try to make something happen with it. Nothing doing. That is big. And the Knights just missed that extra point. So it's going to be 20-13 here. Ooh.
Yeah. Yeah, that's a big miss, because at the end of the quarter, I mean, you could be up and make it a basically a two-point conversion game. Now they can get away with just scoring a touchdown and kicking a field goal and tie it up.
20-13 is the score on the huge Jordan Triplett run.
Right.
The minute and 16 left here in the third quarter.
I think it just took everybody by surprise, but it did. But I mean, awesome run. But it's a minute 16 left in the third quarter. I still feel like I don't know anything about this game.
No, what we know about this game is that we've now got a 7-point lead.
Awesome.
As opposed to that 1-point lead that we
definitely
had earlier.
Definitely.
Look, I will buy that for
$1.
Some
more cushion. Because the thing is, you want to have cushion going into the fourth quarter when the Gators start to try to throw the kitchen sink at you. When, you know, we're behind, the kitchen sink produces the most problems, like it did last game, earlier this season.
Oh, there we go. All right. You turning my microphone off for Calico. I'm trying to make sure I don't interrupt you again. Man, I got to tell you, I've had, you know, regardless of how this turns out, I've had a lot of fun here in the booth with you this year.
Oh, I've definitely been enjoying it. It's like the only normal thing happening.
Yeah. Velocity Zone fireworks kickoff to the 20-yard line. Bounces it to the outside, trying to make something happen, and he gets another 10 yards after that. So a 10-yard return on a decent kick from Frenchman. It's going to be down at just past the 30-yard line, and there is a minute 8 left in the third quarter here.
So just when the defense thought they were going to get a little bit of a break, Triplett breaks out an 85-yard run like a madman.
Got updates on both other – oh, and a penalty on the Knights. What do we have there?
Like a personal foul
after a dead ball penalty, so that's going to take it from the 30 to the 45. Ouch.
Knights did not need that.
No.
You cannot shoot yourself in the foot after making a big play like that. You just can't do it.
All right, so updates in both other Glenn County games. Glenn Academy now adding to the spanking. It's 35-3 against Grovetown between the bricks at Glenn County Stadium. Brunswick High late in the third quarter still zip on the Alcove team. 27-0, Pirates in the lead. Should be coming back from Covington with a win on that one. It's 20-13 here in the borough with a minute 8 left. Bulloch takes back over. After the personal foul penalty, they've got first and 10 at their own 45-yard line. Gives him number 20, and he is met by a couple. It looks like the Wills met him in the backfield. No, I'm sorry, that was Will Thompson and Joshua Elliott actually combining on the tackle there. They're going to give him forward progress back to the line of scrimmage, but I don't think so.
They took him and they drove. They took him and they drove.
They drove him like an Enterprise rent-a-car.
Right. I'm telling you.
Took him and drove him like a Penske from the Home Depot. Took him and drove him like a borrowed set of golf clubs on a public course. Stop me.
I like this. You're doing good.
All right, second and 9 from the 47 here. Quarterback back under center for the Gators. Drives back. He's rolling to the far side. Got a flag. And got pressure coming in the backfield. He's trying to decide what he's going to do. He's got some positive yardage. Finally tucks it and realizes that he can't throw the ball and decides to tuck it. He's down into Frederica territory, but there is a flag on the play way back in the backfield early in that play. I'm going to assume that that was a hold on the Gators.
Definitely. Anytime your quarterback has that much time and he's looking upfield, somebody's doing some grabbing.
It's a false start again. Why are they not stopping the play?
They're not stopping the play.
False start. Is this a new rule for the GISA that we haven't been made aware of?
When there's a false start, the play is supposed to be stopped. It's supposed to be halted.
This will definitely be something we talk to Coach Brandon Derrick about on the Coach Brandon Derrick Show this Sunday night, 8 o'clock at Porch on St. Simon's Island. You can listen to it on 1440 WGIG 98.7 FM. And it's all thanks to Standby Aviation. 11 seconds, and the clock starts ticking, and they wind it up. And they're not going for the line, so that's going to do it for the third quarter. We play three here in the Borough. Your score, 20-13. Frederica in the lead. We are 12 minutes from what looks like a home playoff game against Tift Area next week, but we still got to play that fourth square. We'll be back in just a minute to start the fourth quarter. Frederica Knights football.
Is a full-service event company with a resolution to provide clients with innovative inventory, ideas, and customer service. Our carefully curated collection of tents, lighting, linens, furniture, and tableware are sure to bring your vision to life and create a truly memorable event. The Beachview crew makes sure to bring the creativity, fun, and excellent customer service that has been winning us the appreciation and respect of all our clients for 20 years to each project.
You love the game, but you don't love the pain. From the moment an injury sidelines you, turn to the experts at Summit Sports Medicine and Orthopedic Surgery. Our winning team of physicians and orthopedic surgeons will design a treatment plan just for you, so you can get back in the game quickly and safely. To play your best, you need to work with the best. Visit sghs.org/summit or call 912-466-7340 to schedule your appointment.
The lead here in this first round playoff matchup against the Bulloch Academy Gators. Gators have got second and 14 from their own 42-yard line here to start off the fourth quarter. Shot in the pistol. Quarterback drops it. He's going to try and pitch it out to the sideline. He's got it, and it's going to be maybe enough for the first down. That's on that far sideline there, and it's hard to see where he gets knocked out of bounds.
Yeah, I didn't actually see where he went out of bounds, but they've almost got that pitch down to a T. Yeah. Quarterback holding it a little bit longer right then.
Yeah. It is enough for a first down, and the Gators are into Frederica territory down to the 44-yard line. Got an explanation when we were on break. What it is, they're calling an illegal procedure, which was too many men in the backfield, but the hand signal that the ref is giving is the same signal as the false start, which has gotten us so confused because you never see that on any other layer, any other level of play.
Right.
So that's why they have not been stopping the ball on false start, because it's not false start. First and 10 for the Gators at the Frederica 44-yard line. Here, opening moments of the fourth quarter. 20-13 is the score. Frederica's got the lead. Bullis got it. Here's the snap. Quarterback looking to throw. Cuts to the other side. He's going to get tripped up and brought down after a gain of about 4 yards up to the 40-yard line. It's going to be second and 6 from the looks of it.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, Spears and Spencer making a big tackle right there because he cut it back up. He had a lot of playroom, a lot of greenery.
All right, update from Covington. Brunswick High now 34-0 over Alcoa.
Cakewalk.
Both of the other Glenn County teams. We're the ones that are actually giving you some drama tonight, folks. 20-13 to score. Bullock has now got second 6 from the Frederica 40-yard line. Quarterback back into the pistol. Single back to number 20. They're going to try that again. He tries to trip him up, and the quarterback keeps it. He's going to have a first down the sideline. He's going to be pushed out of bounds at about the 26-yard line, but another first down for the Gators, and they're driving here.
Yeah, the Gators are moving down the field, and the Knights got to figure out a way to keep them out the end zone or make them spend some more of that clock.
Yep. 11:05 is where the clock stops with that quarterback for the Gators getting knocked out of bounds here.
The way this game is going, it almost seems like whoever has the last possession will be the winner.
Man, I hate thinking about games like that.
That's what it looks like.
All right. First and 10 from the 26 for the Gators. They're thinking over this one hard. They played 3 at Glenn County. 35-3 is the score there.
Cakewalk.
First and 10 from the 26. Quarterback back under center. He's going to give it to number 20. And he's going to be busted up on that one. He's going to lose a couple on the play. Whole bunch of Frederica Knights coming through the line on that one. And I do believe, unless I am horribly mistaken, that was Will Counts that led the way.
Definitely, definitely. When you get a chance to hit somebody like that, gang tackle them, make sure they feel it. Busted play. Yeah, everybody gets a hit at them.
And of course, the coaches, the CEO of the coaches' office has finally reached out to explain it to me. Thank you for that, Becky. False start, the motion is the hands are in fists. Illegal procedure, the hands are flat.
So thank you so much.
Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah.
Another nugget of wisdom from the real brains behind the administration.
We were getting angry. Yeah, we definitely were.
Quarterback back under center for the Gators, sends a tight end in motion, single receiver to the near side. Here's the snap, gives the big number two again. He's met again with the line. They're trying to push it forward. He's trying to bust it to the outside and finally gets brought down. Not a lot on that. Some hard-fought yardage. So it's going to be third down and,
about nine?
Kind of hard to see. They're down to the 23-yard line.
Okay, so they're saying third and four.
We gotta pay better. We just had to look at the actual lines instead of looking at the scoreboard.
Right.
It's third and manageable for the Gators.
Yeah.
That's what it looks like. 20-13, your score here. Frederica in the lead, but Bulloch trying to even the score. Third and seven from the 24-yard line is what they're looking at. That empty backfield again. Four receivers to the near side, one to the far. Quick out, and it's going to be complete. But he falls, and he's going to be short of the fourth down. I've heard some folks saying that this is four down territory, and I wouldn't blame them.
Definitely. The Gators are going to have to make a decision whether they want to be aggressive or give the ball back to the Knights. I would not give the ball back to Jordan Triplett, though, after that 85-yard run.
Here we go. Fourth and four from the 19, and yes, indeed, the Knights the Gators are keeping their offense back out there.
But this will be a major, this could swing the game if the Knights get a stop.
Okay, here's what we got. Quarterback back into the shotgun. He's got big number 20 to his right. Trip receivers to the far side, one to the near. Here's the snap. Quarterback rolling to the right side. He's got pressure coming in from the inside. Cuts it. He's got the first down. Tripped up. Wow.
Woo.
Man, that was a touchdown saving tackle there from Jaden Rose Scally. That quarterback went flying through the air. If Rose had not gotten his shoestring tackle on him, that would have been
right.
Another six.
Major save.
Wow. But so they've got first and goal from the 10-yard line.
This is about to be four at a hardest
down. No, I'm sorry. It's not first. Is it first and goal?
No, it's first and 10. No, ball on the 10.
It's on the 10. Okay, so it's on the 10. Yeah, first and goal from the 10. Yeah. Two receivers to the near side. They're on the far hash mark. Single receiver to the other side. Quarterback takes it. He's going to try and dance through it. He's going to get a couple yards, but finally gets met. He's going to get it down to about the 6-yard line, so 4 yards on it. So it's going to be second and goal from the 6.
Yeah, Josh Elliott jumping in the gap and making that tackle. Now, I tell you what, this clock is ticking in the fourth quarter. Already under 8 minutes.
Yep, 7:45 and counting here. Second and goal from the 6-yard line. Frederica with a 20-13 lead, but the Gators are looking to trim that score. Knights defense have been pretty solid throughout the season in the red zone. I just keep remembering that first and goal from the 5 against Pinewood a couple weeks ago, that they were able to force them out on that one.
They held it down.
That they did. Second and 6 here for the Gators. Here's the snap. Give us number 2 trying to take it up the middle. Nothing doing. No, he keeps moving that line. Holy cow.
Golly.
Wow, he kept those feet. They met him out of the 5, and he kept those feet going. Carried the line, carried the scrum another 4 yards. Takes it down to the 1-yard line. Woo. Oh, my goodness. Play. Mary Mother.
Biggest play of the game right here we're approaching.
Absolutely.
Third and 1. Third and goal from the 1. They're going wild. They're not wild.
Nope. Quarterback keeps it himself. Going to try and take it up the middle, and it's good. Touchdown. Bulloch gets the quarterback sneak straight up the middle for the score.
Yeah. Like I said, we know nothing about this game.
Yep, that is a fact. Quarterback for the Just heard from the announcer for Bulloch Academy, their starting place kicker is has not been been playing tonight. Oh, so they're having backup kickers here. Let's see what we got.
It's good to know.
All right, this is critical here. Here's the snap. Placement is no good. It is low. Hit the referee in the knee, believe it or not.
And the Knights maintain the lead.
20-19. Let's take a quick break. 30 seconds. Frederica Knights football, 103Q, Christmas on Q. Bulloch Academy brings it back to within one, a missed extra point. Maintains the Frederica Knights lead. 20-19 is the score here. Frederica in the lead with 6:33 left in this first round playoff game in the GISA. Ready for another Velocity Zone fireworks kickoff. They've been kicking almost exclusively to Eli Fritchman, short into the near side. He's standing at about the 30. Let's see if they do that again. And that is indeed what they are doing it again. To Fritchman, he calls for the fair catch, and that is where he'll catch it squarely at the 33-yard line.
I think we're about to see some run-heavy night football.
Man, I hope so. And this is yet another one of those nights that I'm glad my wife is a cardiology nurse. I just wish she wasn't an hour and a half away.
And listen, you want about two or three first downs to seal the game, but even if you don't, you want to eat up at least 30 seconds. 30 seconds each down.
Yep. All right. First and 10 for the Knights at the 33-yard line. You know, adding some more points, that would be nice. All right, here we go. Here's the snap. And that is Triplett again in the Wildcat formation, straight up the middle. He's got one man to beat. Gets tripped up, but not before he gets another fair and fair. A first down into Frederica territory, or excuse me, into Bulloch territory, down to the 45-yard line. Man.
This is Jordan Triplett's first playoff game, high school playoff game. And I'm excited to see him in a playoff.
He is not. Yeah, he is not playing like a freshman, I'll tell you that. But he is playing like somebody that a major ACC team has been scouting, and that makes complete and total sense.
Definitely.
All right, again, they're lining up again in the Cherokee formation. The Frederica, the Coach Brandon Derrick version of the Wildcat formation. Rose Scally and Riley to the near side. McGraw to the far side. Triplett in the backfield, sends Rose Scally in motion. The give is to him, tries to get it around the corner. Nothing doing. He actually loses 4 yards in the play back to the 49-yard line.
Yeah, so it looks like we're going to see Wildcat from here on out.
Yeah.
Getting some of that clock. And like I said, even if you don't keep converting first downs, you need to at least eat up 30 seconds every play possession.
They're doing pretty good so far.
Definitely.
Second and 13 now with 5:30 and counting left in the game. Quick update, Glen Academy now up 42-3 over Grovetown.
Wow.
Five 15 and counting here. Here's the snap, Rose Scally in motion, but Velas or Triplett gonna keep it himself. Gets back, the lost yards penalty flag comes in. Let's see what we got. He gets about five, six, seven yards on the play.
Yeah, it was a nice, decent run. Mm-hmm.
What do we have on the penalty? Still waiting to see. Looking like it's going to be holding on the Knights. They're going to back it up again, try it again.
Yeah.
But the thing about it is that clock still kept moving. That's the more important thing for right now.
Exactly.
5:05 left on the scoreboard. 20-19 is the score. And they should be winding that. So once they get it placed back, should wind the clock again, keep it rolling. but it'll be second and long.
And that's the most important thing they're getting right now is the movement of the clock.
Yep, second and 17 from the Frederica 48-yard line here. And there's that clock. We're now inside of 5 minutes. Woo. 20-19 is the score.
This is the tail of the tape right here. This is the game.
All right, here's the snap. Veal keeps it, or Tripper keeps it straight up the middle. Run man to beat, he's got a first down. It's a foot race down the far sidelines. He's going to be in for another touchdown. The River Jordan Tripper, 52 yards in his first playoff game, playing like a senior, but my God, a freshman.
There it goes. You see it as the night goes on. It's cold. It's a little bit colder than it has been earlier in the season. When you continue to hit a running back like that, when we've been seeing the Knights attack the middle, now it's just playing on tire to hit. And, I mean, that's the third big run we've seen in the last two series from Jordan Tripper.
52-yard touchdown scamper for the River Jordan Tripper. Wait, did they? They say he got, okay, no. Wow. They're going for two. Are they going for two? No, they're not. That's Fritchman. Oh, he was, okay, that was what it was. Okay. No, this is, they're going for the extra point here. 52-yard touchdown run from Triplett. Here we go. Fritchman back with extra point duties. It is up. It's long. It's good. 27-19 with 4:38 left in the game. Are we ready for a break?
Let's take a break.
We'll be back 30 seconds. Frederica Knights football, Christmas on cue. From the Cherokee formation, 52-yard touchdown run for the River Jordan Triplett, and it's 27-19. Frederica putting a little cushion on this match with 4:38 left in the fourth quarter of this first round playoff game. Here's the velocity zone fireworks kickoff is going to be fielded in the back of the end zone. And they're going to say, yeah, no, they'll say it's down. Automatic down in the end zone. So first and 10 from the 20 for the Gators here.
That was good for us because I would want to see him return it.
Yeah, no, that's the, you don't, those are the kind of plays that you don't want to see with 4:38 and the game on the line.
And the thing is, there's still so much game and these Gators score so quick. I'm interested in seeing how the Knights are going to respond to being up. Playing from the top.
Let's see what happens. They're going to have to watch those sidelines. Going to have to watch those flats. Watch that option play. That's been the one that's stuck the knife in them several times tonight.
Yep.
All right, shotgun formation for the Knights. Two receivers either side. Quarterback rolls out to the far side. He's looking. There's not going to be an option. There's a flag coming down from both on the far side there. Let's see what we got. It's going to be a big loss if it stands. But let's see what the penalty flag is. That's going to be a hold against the Gators, so that goes Frederica's way. 4:31 left on the clock here. 27-19, your score.
Big play, man. DeLon Spencer getting back there, a couple of linebackers getting back there and making a stop.
All right. Second and 17, loss of 7 on the play with the penalty. So they got it back at their own 14-yard line now, or 13-yard line now. Second and 17 here for the Gators. This has been the cleanest refereeing game that we have played in Statesboro.
Oh, definitely.
Ever.
No holds barred.
Quarterback in the shotgun, two receivers either side, single back to his near side. Tries a little jump pass, gets it to the back to number two. Uh-oh, and he's going to look brought down. Wow, no blocking, no help, no love from his lineman downfield on that one. He's going to get, wow,
What a tackle by Bryce
Riley. Get back to the line of scrimmage.
He literally caught the ball in all the traffic. Not a little bit of traffic, but all the traffic. And Hill was trying to take it around the corner. Bryce Riley just making a big play and a big stop for the Knights.
It's a jump shot alley-oop style pass from the quarterback there, getting it over the lineman. He was able to bring it down and was trying to run for that sideline, which he's been so dangerous on all night, but just not getting any block and no help. And he winds up only getting back to the line of scrimmage. 3rd and 17 now from the 13-yard line. Coming up on 3 minutes left in the game. 27-19 to score. Knights in the lead. Here's the snap. Quarterback looking to throw again. Quick out. Oh, man, Bryce Riley. He read that one all day long.
Definitely.
But was able to make the completion. It's nowhere near enough for the first down, though. But they're absolutely, even though they're deep in their own territory, this has got to be four down territory.
Yeah, this is definitely do or die.
And it was incomplete. It was incomplete. That wasn't a completion. So it's going to be 4th and 17 at the 13.
Man.
Holy macanudos.
Nice to get the chance to come out here and make a big stop. And is this the point? Is this the punt team?
I think. I don't know.
Yeah, it looks like punt team.
Maybe. Yeah, they're punting it.
Wow.
You know what? It's the other team, but I disagree on that one. Watch for the fake here, though.
Right. Definitely watch for the fake.
Richmond and is that Roscalli on the other side, or is that Perez? Here's the snap. They are not faking it. It is an actual punt, and it's going to be Richmond again. Did not call for the fair catch, but held on to it at the 40. Was trying to dodge some, unable to do so. But so we've got it with great field position. We've got it 1st and 10 from the Bulloch Academy 40-yard line with 3 minutes left to play. Are we good on breaks, or are we?
We're good on breaks.
Okay, let's stay right here. I didn't want to go away anyway, man. There's too much excitement going on here. 27-19, the Knights are in the lead here with 3 minutes left to play. After the punt, they have got 1st and 10 from the Bulloch Academy 40-yard line, and you got to think this is going to be nothing but a steady diet of the River Jordan triplet. Maybe a little bit of Jaden Roscalli.
Yeah.
Got to get some Meatball Perez back in there as well.
Definitely. And this is as in the driver's seat as it's been all night.
All season. Well, with the exception of last week, 62-0 but still.
Yeah.
Wow. All right, 1st and 10 for the Knights. Back into the Cherokee formation again. Triplett standing back at the 45-yard line. Going to send Roscalli in motion. Keeps it himself. Cuts it back up the middle. He's going to get back to the line of scrimmage. Back to the line of scrimmage. And timeout for Bulloch Academy here. So it's going to be 2nd and 10 when we come back from the Bulloch Academy timeout. We don't need the timeout here.
No, we're good. We're good.
We are good. Man, we're going to have a lot to talk about Sunday night.
Definitely.
At the Coach Brandon Derrick Show. In case you missed it, it's 8 o'clock every Sunday night. At Porch on St. Simon's, Nashville Hot Chicken, just the way you like it, and the best ice cream sandwich in the Golden Isles, period.
Period?
Period. Full
stop.
They
got different flavors, or is it like all the just
you
the,
got
the chocolate,
chocolate, you got vanilla.
Vanilla.
You know, but for me, if it's an ice cream sandwich, it's got to be vanilla.
Okay. Yeah, right. definitely.
When it comes to my ice cream, I'm pretty plain about that.
Yeah.
I used to like the Ben & Jerry's, but every time I would get a new favorite flavor, those psychic hippie jerkwads would cancel it.
Yeah.
They would cancel it. One of my favorite flavors, they've canceled it twice.
Which one?
There was Cool Britannia.
Yeah.
Cool Britannia was vanilla with a strawberry swirl and chocolate-covered shortcakes mixed into it.
That's
it was great, but they canceled it. Then they brought it back a couple years later as Situation Normal all fudged up.
Yeah.
And they canceled it again. So I've given up on Ben & Jerry's because they can read my mind. They can tell what my favorite flavor is, and they just dangle it in front of me and then toss it out the window. Like so much used ice cream.
They don't know how to keep it for you.
Nope, they don't. All right, so we're back to actual football. 27-19 is the score here with 2:55 left in the game. 2nd and 10 from the 40-yard line. Roscalli in motion, fakes the give to him. Triplett keeps it himself again up the middle, dodging, avoiding, trying to use the referee as an additional blocker. He's going to get close to the first down. It's going to be close to a fair and fair first down. Yeah, it is a first down. Right. That part, the line should say move and change, guys. Fair and fair, a first down for the Knights, and the clock continues to roll, 2:45 and counting.
Yeah, when I see Jordan Triplett run, and he just when he hops out with that almost like LaDainian Tomlinson type sidestep, it's just like he has it down pat to be so young. He just knows that move. And he instantly could be running, get 2-3 yards, go into that sidestep and cut up for 8 more.
Still in the Cherokee formation for the Knights. Got Riley and Rose Scaly to the near side. You got a penalty flag coming in. And that's going to be a delay of game on the Knights. So the clock stops at 2:14 here.
Yeah. You can hear Coach Derek.
Yeah, Coach Derek, there you go. The coach is like, we didn't realize that the play clock had started. He's not happy about that one.
Not at all.
And there are people in the booth here that agrees with us on that one. That's the sad thing. Come on, Coach, just ease up. We don't need you causing a ruckus this close to the end, all right? Here's the snap. A fakes again to Rose Scaly. Going on the far side again. Triplett's got it. He's got the first down. We've got one man to spin out and beat. Driving for the end zone. Touchdown, Jordan Triplett.
He literally spent his way into the end zone. He went in backwards. He went in backwards.
Man, that was a thing of beauty.
He went in backwards.
Fake the handoff to Rose Scaly. Let him get in front of him as the lead blocker. Takes it around the far side, down the sideline. Dodges a couple of tacklers. And then finally, one final tackler spins out of it at the one-yard line in for the score. 35-yard touchdown run for the freshman.
And he backpedaled into the end zone.
And I think it's just about done here.
Yeah.
Back in for the extra point is Vinatiera. He gets the extra point. It's good. 34-19 is the score.
So we're looking at home next week.
That's the way it's looking, unless something really freaky goes on here. I'm not even.
Yeah. I'm telling you. These guys got some athletes, but we're not going to talk about that.
Yep. This is, and the thing about it is, once again, let's take a look at records on this. This will be only the third time that the visiting team has won a game in this series.
Wow.
2019 and 2018 were the only times that the visiting team has won the matchup in Bulloch versus Frederica.
Road Warriors.
That it is indeed. So again, with the touchdown and the extra point, 34-19 is your score here with 2:04 left on the clock. And do you start rotating in at this point? I would hesitate to think so.
Not yet, because you just don't know what kind of big play is going to pop off. And you need to have cushion for that.
Velocity Zone Fireworks kickoff going to be fielded at the 25. Tries to take it up the middle. Wrapped up by who else but Josh Meadows. Josh Meadows and Will Counts together on the stop. So they're going to be back at the 32-yard line, I believe.
Yep, up to 32.
All right, minute 59 left in the game. And it's a final between the bricks at Glenn County Stadium. The Glenn Academy Red Terriers victorious over Grovetown, 42-3. 3 minutes left in the game up in Covington, 41-0. Brunswick High in the lead and well in control on that one. We've got just under 2 minutes here in the borough, and it's 34-19.
Hard to believe it's 34-19. The game we've been watching, but I mean, just probably four big runs from Jordan Triplett in this fourth quarter has been crazy.
You know, I would have never thought after everything, and I don't know why I didn't think about it, because I knew that Coach was saying that he was thinking about adding a couple of little things. I don't know why I didn't think about the Cherokee. I didn't even think about that being the case. All right, quarterback in the shotgun for the Gators. Rolling back to pass, trying to spin out of it. He's brought down by his coattails.
That was Jacob Aiken
shaking and bacon, bringing down the quarterback for the first sack of the night.
Man, I mean, he held on to him. Literally spent around in a circle.
Yeah, he got that full grasp at the coattails and able to hold on to him, bring him down at the 28-yard line. So 2nd and 16 with a minute 30 left. Shotgun formation again for the Gators. Here's the snap. Dropping back, looking to pass, throwing it far down the sideline. It's going to be completed. Oh, my goodness. It's going to be a touchdown. Right over the fingertips of the defender and able to go 72 yards for the touchdown.
And that's what I talk about, being asleep in the secondary, not being ready.
Yep.
That's what happens, and you have to defend. You have to defend that big play. The Gators have been scoring quick all night. I already expected them to come out like that on their last drive, the do-or-die drive.
Yeah, minute 15 left. Stranger things have happened. but just an absolutely massive throw. Great concentration from the receiver down on the sideline, able to keep it in stride and caught it in stride.
In stride. And
did not have to adjust at all. I mean, just a beautiful, beautiful pass.
Oh, it was nice.
I just wish it was us that had made it. All right. Going for two. Here's the snap. Quarterback rolling out to the far side, looking to throw, and it's going to be good. They got the two-point conversion. It's completed.
So we're right back in the tight, and Bulloch has two timeouts. So do we. We have two timeouts. Bulloch has two timeouts as well. So.
All right. So with a minute 15 left, it's now 34-27. It's a one-score game with that two-point conversion.
And if you're not familiar, for these two teams to be one score away from each other or have this going on within the last minute, this is, feels common. This is like commonplace for us.
34-27. Minute 15. And you got to think this is going to be an onside kick coming here.
Oh, definitely.
This game is coming down to the wire. And as a Bulldog fan, every time they start playing their fight song, it makes me want to stab at somebody's eye out with a rusty spoon. Especially this year. I mean, I know the Perez family are Gator fans. I know that. And I love the Perez's. I really do. But dang. I'm sorry. All right, minute 15. Gators lining up for the onside kick. They're heavy to the near side of the field. Let's see what we got going on here. And, wow, okay, yes, this is an NFL-style. Okay, flag coming from the backfield. We got a that's a delay of game there.
Delay of game?
Yep. Nope. No, that was, what was that? The one hand across the heart. It's on the Knights.
Yeah.
Too many men on the field? What?
Wow.
Yeah, yeah, there's 12 men on the field right now.
Everybody was out there trying to stop this. No on.
Okay, yeah, there's, I mean, this, it's, okay. Yep. 1, 2, 3, 4, 6, 7, 9, 10, 11. Okay, now we're good. Let's try that again. And here with the onside kick. It's on the ground. Knights are pointing Knights, and there's the referee saying that the Knights did recover the onside kick at the 40-yard line, and the crowd rejoices on the far side, at least those that are not frozen to their seats.
Right.
Minute 11 left in the game. The Gators can stop the clock twice. They've still got two timeouts left.
First down, first down, first down.
So yet again, we need ourselves a steady diet of the River Jordan triplet.
Which out of this Cherokee has been unstoppable pretty much all night.
Yeah, he's out there again, keeping it in the Cherokee formation. Rose Scally takes a step over to him to calm him down a little bit. Bryce Riley is in the receiver slot to the near side. He's in the Z to the near side. Rose Scally in the slot receiver spot. McGraw on the far side. Rose Scally in motion. Fake is to him. Triplet keeps it himself. Gets it forward. Gets it back to the line of scrimmage. And there's that first of the two timeouts from the Gators. Clock stops at a minute 7 here.
So four seconds rolling off the clock. Just only 4 seconds.
34-27 is the score after that huge touchdown pass, 72 yards from the Gators here moments ago. Trimming the lead, and then with a two-point conversion, making it a one-score game.
Yeah, it was definitely explosive. Caught me off guard.
Yeah. Here I was talking about ice cream sandwiches, and the game was technically still on the line. That's what I get, I reckon.
Right.
All right, 41-6 is the score. The Alcove finally getting points on the board against Brunswick High.
That's pretty much over.
But, yeah, pretty much over. It just feels weird as a Pirate alumni knowing that my alma mater is making it to the second round of the playoffs. Don't get me wrong, I'm happy about it.
Right.
Not as happy as what will hopefully be happening here in 67 seconds.
We'll see.
One more timeout they've got in their pockets here, the Gators. And Frederica's got it now. Second and 9 from the 43-yard line with a minute 7 Roscali in motion. Here's the snap. Fakes the give to him. He's blocking for him. Veal rolling through again. Gets it to midfield. So almost to midfield. Are they going to put him down? Yeah, they're going to put him down at the 50-yard line. And Bulloch takes their final timeout. This will be third and one here.
Big play coming up.
Yeah, with no timeouts left, as the announcer just said, we first down here, and the season is over for the Bulloch Academy Gators. Let's see what we got. 61 seconds left. 61 seconds between the Frederica Knights and a second-round playoff matchup.
Yeah, everybody's advanced tonight. We got to advance.
Yeah, we can't be the only Glenn County school not to to get a second-round dance card.
We've got to advance.
And it is a final. Tift area upsetting Pinewood Christian Academy, 28-7. So 61 seconds away from the Frederica Knights getting a home game next week. Third and one from the 50-yard line. Back into the Cherokee formation for the Knights. Two receivers to the far side, one to the near side. Jordan Triplett lined up in the Wildcat to the Cherokee formation. Here's the snap. Jordan Triplett in Roscali in motion. Triplett keeps himself. He's got the first down into Bulloch territory down to the 41-yard line. And that, as they say in the old country, is all she wrote.
Man, that's game time.
Clock stops at 56 seconds, long enough to move the chains. And then it starts rolling again. And it's all a matter of a couple of victory formations for these Knights. And they're heading back under the Oaks for the second round of the GISA playoffs to take on the Tift area Captain Panthers. Hopefully get a little bit of payback. Tift area being one of the three losses that the Knights faced in the regular season. But man, Coach Brandon Derrick's team comes into Statesboro and plays one heck of a fourth quarter. Because remember, this game at the beginning of the fourth quarter was still very much in doubt.
And that's all that matters is taking over the end of the game, closing out the game, and we've seen the Knights close out a game.
Yep. Now, the Knights just took a timeout. I'm not entirely certain why, but it's down to 19 seconds left on the clock. So, you know what? I don't ask questions. I'm just here to commentate.
Right. That's a nice-looking score, though, for a playoff game.
It is. 34-27 is more than likely, unless something really wonky happens here in the last 19 seconds. But that's going to be your final score here. We can talk about it all night long, but we got to get back to the Christmas music. You want to hear more about this game, though, you are more than welcome to join us at the Coach Brandon Derrick Show this Sunday night, 8 o'clock, at Porch on St. Simon's right there on Ocean Boulevard. And Nashville hot chicken the way that Mother Nature intended. It is good stuff.
I got to try it.
One of these nights, I'm just going to have to. No, we need to get Brock. To give up the family on Sunday night, come out to run the board so Callie can join me at the Porch one Sunday night. 8 o'clock, brought to you by Standby Aviation on 1440 WGIG 98.7 FM. There's the snap. Final 15 seconds ticking off, and a jubilant Meatball Perez hyping up the crowd as he heads to the sidelines. And that, ladies and gentlemen, is that. We're 3 seconds, 2-1, and zeros on the scoreboard. Your Frederica Knights are heading to the second round of the playoffs. Final score from the borough, Frederica Academy 34, Bulloch Academy 27. We'll be back in just a moment to wrap things up. It's Frederica Knights football on Christmas on Cue.